This is the story of the purchase and restoration of a 1962 Oldsmobile Starfire. I'd wanted a Starfire for many years, and found the car I was to purchase in Grand Junction, Colorado, where it spent its lifetime until late July 2005. The Starfire arrived in Windsor, Ontario, July 27, 2005, to receive a complete restoration and a new life. I'm the second owner of the car. Here's information and provenance of this 1962 Oldsmobile Starfire. So far, you've seen pictures of what the car looks like today, but when it arrived in Windsor, it didn't look anything at all like that. Here's how it looked then. All of the rust holes on this car were caused by trapped water and mud over many years. Road salt was not used in Colorado in the wintertime, and so the car is salt-free, but certainly not rust-free. As you could see, the car needed a lot of work, and it got it. Step one was to rebuild the carburetor, and then its first major complete tune-up. The next step was making the car roadworthy and safe to drive. And so new tie rod ends replaced the old, and grease nipples were added. New stabilizers. New springs and shocks all the way around. Everything about the brake system was made new or better than new. New radial white wall tires all around. An original bias ply spare remains in the trunk. And then to the alignment shop. Next, we removed and pressure checked the rad, which was in excellent condition, and flushed out the cooling system. New lines, hoses, and tubes were added. A new battery. A cracked window vent was replaced with an old original window. Directional signal actuators have a tendency to break easily on these cars. They're not made anymore, and they're extremely hard to find. But we found an NOS actuator and replaced the old one. The actuators return the signal arm to the neutral position. All underdash wiring was thoroughly checked, and all that needed replacement was replaced with new. Over the decades, the entire underside of the car had become caked with grease, grime, and dirt from Colorado roads. And so we power washed and hand scrubbed it three times for a clean finish. The underside is still power washed and hand scrubbed on a regular basis to keep it clean. The engine, engine compartment, and transmission were also hand scrubbed and power washed several times, and this continues today as well. The transmission was checked out thoroughly and found to be in excellent condition. New fluid and filter were added. There's still plenty more work to be done, so it's off to the body shop for 8 weeks of intensive and complete body restoration. No Bondo in this car. All rusted panels were replaced with new hand-formed solid steel and butt-welded together for a seamless fit, as you can see in this example. The rear bumper was strengthened, straightened, and triple chromed. Now a final sanding before heading off to the paint shop. The original color on the Starfire was white, which did not contrast well with the stainless, chrome, and aluminum brightwork on the car. We wanted something that would give it a little more distinction. And so, after months of thought, an original GM color was chosen. Madeira Maroon makes a perfect contrast. There's no overspray anywhere, and the entire body is fully coated with one coat of base coat and three coats of clear coat. The inner wheel wells will be done in black later on. Here's a look at the interior midway through the restoration. But now it's time to put everything back together. All weather stripping, rubber bumpers, rubber moldings, etc. were replaced throughout the entire car. Armrests and other plastics in the Starfire were re-chromed. Every inch of chrome, stainless, and other brightwork was polished to a brilliant shine. It's a task that took several days to complete, and it was all done by hand. Here's a before and after example. While the Starfire was in the body shop, we used the time to rebuild and reupholster the rear seat. A little later, you'll see how a completely new interior was added. It's taken a full 8 weeks and endless hours of work and craftsmanship. But the car is finally out of the body shop, as good as new or better than new. Now to the detailing shop for a full hand cleaning inside and out. Here are a few before and after shots, which will put things in perspective. The aerial was removed from the front of the car to the rear fender. There was pitting on the right front panel, and so the panel was replaced. Here's what the old rear seats looked like. And here's what they look like today. The engine was again power washed and hand scrubbed. Once again, all the electrics on the Starfire were checked and rechecked. All interior and exterior bulbs were replaced with new. Over the years, the gear indicator lens had become scratched and weathered. It was time for a replacement, but they're not making these anymore. The answer was to have a new one custom made. The next upgrade was a new trunk-mounted CD stereo system and about 18 CDs playing all the top hits of the late 50s to mid-60s. Two new speakers were added to the rear deck and two more in the front seating area for surround stereo. Now that that's done, a new custom trunk will be added. Every inch of this trunk was custom made and hand fabricated to specifications, including new side panels and a custom spare tire cover. It's time to work on radios. A new FM radio was inset in the glove compartment. For a more professional and finished look, we made a new mini glove box right next to the FM radio. Now it's time to replace the old AM radio and AM speaker with an original refurbished model. Over the years, red trim brightwork had faded or peeled off. It was time to replace it. Safety is of prime importance. The Starfire didn't come with seat belts, and so new belts were added to the front and rear, along with new control arm bushings. It's time to replace the old dual exhaust system from front to back. Notice the excellent condition of the original floor pans. Remember, this car came from Colorado, where no salt was used in the wintertime. Keeping the floor solid and rust-free meant power washing and hand scrubbing the underside again, and adding the best rust-proofing we could find. POR-15 was sprayed over the entire underside of the car. Anyone who knows rust-proofing will tell you, POR-15 is tough stuff. Nothing gets through it, and it doesn't crack. Old panel inserts in the trunk lid were showing their age. It was time to replace them. And they'll be replaced again for an even better look, as you'll see later on. More safety features were added. Four-way flashers. Daytime running lights. A security alarm system. And backup radar. Over the years, the dash had become scratched and faded. It needed a new look, and so fresh, matching paint was applied. You'll recall that during body shop restorations, we strengthened, straightened, and triple-chromed the rear bumper. Now it was time to do the same thing to the front bumper. rust was beginning to show on tips of both bumpers. The first step was to make sure that the front bumper was stronger than new. It was then sent off to the shop to be triple plated with show chrome. And here it is, back on the car. As the bumper was in the plating shop, we made a new custom trunk floor mat with raised letters and gave it a plastic covering for protection. This mat is now in storage. It isn't used anymore. We've now added compartments to the trunk well, as you'll see later in this video. At the same time, a custom-made bumper jack case was being made. The jack was then sent out for chrome plating to give it a more exclusive look. Installing a new interior in the Starfire is still about a year away at this point, but a few plastic transverse strips across the interior of the roof needed immediate attention due to cracking. Finding these in good condition is a little like looking for a needle in a haystack. They're plastic after all, and a lot of them had cracked over the years. But we were lucky to find a complete set in good shape. These were then sent out for re-chrome plating. Headliner panels were then removed, and the new strips were installed. And here's how they look today. Old headlights on the Starfire were in excellent condition, but they didn't cast enough light for today's modern driving. The answer was to replace them with new halogen headlights. These provide plenty of light for safe night driving. Anyone who's looked under the hood of an old car will likely know that in most cases, the dust shields are missing. That was the case with the Starfire. The answer was new dust shields to keep debris from getting into the engine compartment. It's time to finish work on the engine compartment. That means another power washing and hand scrubbing before starting in. We checked the engine over thoroughly, painted it the correct color, and added a new set of valve seals. Here's the engine with the valve covers replaced. The old generator wasn't producing enough power, and so we replaced it with a new chromed 100 amp alternator. New brackets had to be hand formed to accomplish this. Old hood insulation was removed and new hood insulation installed. Engine upgrades continued with new gaskets, and that meant cracking open the engine one more time. Here's the valley pan being cleaned before replacement in the engine. The engine was checked out a second time with a different mechanic, and all came back A-OK. The next upgrade involved replacing the old blow-by tube with a new PCV valve system to burn up crankcase gases. Makes the engine purr like a kitten. A new fuel pump was added. During its long life, every car has been subjected to parking lot dings. It happens. And here's an example. Here's how we removed those dings and made the stainless smooth and shiny again. Time has a way of making power windows slow and sluggish. To make for faster, smoother action, motors were removed and reconditioned. Interior working parts were removed, inspected, lubricated, and returned to the car, and where necessary, brackets were re-welded for extra strength. Then comes the time-consuming task of getting the snugness and balance just right for a perfect fit to eliminate wind whistles. New beltline rubber moldings and felts were added. We're still a long way from finished. The Starfire is about to get a complete new interior. The first step is to remove the old interior. You'll recall that we've rebuilt and reupholstered the rear seat much earlier. It's now time to do the rest. The old rear side panels were removed, recolored, and fully reconditioned to look like new. A lot of thought went into the interior colors and materials to create a relaxed and yet elegant look. Front seats, like rear seats, were rebuilt, and plenty of stuffing was added for comfortable seating. Here's the new interior panels and seating. We're not finished yet. The next step is carpeting. Here are before and after examples. There are 2 inches of insulation beneath the carpeting to make it feel soft underfoot and reduce road noises. High-density soundproofing was added to the door panels as well, and the rear side panels. One of the interior door panels had deteriorated, and so new hardboard was added. Interior chrome was polished to a high shine, and new carpeting was added to the lower part of both door panels. Pins were epoxied to the inside of the panel to hold it to the door for a smooth, clean look. Here's the finished product on both left and right doors. There's still more work to be done to the interior. These are metal dash ends and vent covers being prepared for refinishing. And here they are back in place. New vent window crank guards and rubber moldings were added for the rear windows and vent frame tips. The stylized name Starfire was stitched into the spare tire cover. You'll recall that we earlier replaced the old trunk panel inserts with new inserts. Well, now it's time to do it all over again for an even better look. These new inserts match the trunk carpeting exactly for a finished professional look. We wanted to protect the new carpeting with floor mats, but the Starfire is a large 1962 model, and finding correct size floor mats is difficult. The answer was to make them. The stylized name Starfire is stitched into the floor mats, which are rubber-backed to prevent dirt and water from leaking through. One never knows what road or climate conditions are going to be like. Halogen fog lamps are ideal during inclement weather to help you see better. But we were concerned about destroying the original outward appearance of the Starfire by adding something that looked added on. Well, the answer was to add the lamp brackets to the underhood panel just above the grill. This concealed the fog lights from view behind the grill, and yet allows the light to shine through onto the roadway when required. The underhood panel was then repainted. The next project was to change the firewall color from black to Madeira maroon to match the rest of the car. To accomplish this, the car was masked off, and color match paint was applied. Anyone with an older car will be all too aware of steering wheel cracks caused by the sun and other effects. Here's how those cracks looked on the Starfire. We wanted to get rid of them, and so the wheel was removed and work begun to repair. And here's the finished result. We then buffed and polished the steering wheel and dash brightwork to a brilliant shine. Back in 2005, the master cylinder was rebuilt along with other major brakework. Now it was time to do it again to ensure safety. It's doubtful there are many electric clocks on classic cars that keep accurate time. I know the clock on the Starfire was no exception. Seemed like we were resetting it every few days. And so we took the old clock out and replaced it with a quartz movement. It now keeps perfect time. The Starfire label on the carburetor breather had peeled off in places. It was looking pretty ragged. A new breather label was added to make it look like new again. Everyone seems to have a lot of, stuff to carry around in their classic car. Emergency road equipment, polishing cloths, a spare gas can, extra bulbs, fuses, who knows what all. That's a lot of clutter. One solution for classic cars with a deep well trunk might be trunk compartments. That's how we solved the problem in the Starfire. Well, that's about it for now. As you can see, there have been a lot of upgrades made to this car. But more upgrades and more improvements are on the way. Stay tuned. There's more information to come in the months and years ahead. Thanks for viewing.